बिजनेस रिसर्च पैथर्स एनालिटिक्स।
यस सर।
यस सर।
ओके फाइन। सो वेलकम बैक एंड गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। एंड दिस इज अ लेक्चर 3 एंड लेक्चर 2 एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट वी टॉक अबाउट डिफरेंट डायमेंशन डिफरेंट डोमेन वेयर वी कैन यूज अ बिजनेस रिसर्च और अ रिसर्च। And this domain would be somewhere directly or indirectly linked with the business activity. And business activity is not just only manufacturing of goods and services and transfer it to the final consumer. It's about and that we need to understand consumer, we need to understand consumer psychology, plus we need to understand the local environment. We need to understand what kind of resources we have. So different dimensions we have if you think of just a business activity. So business activity has become very important, more important now, because now beside buying a product which comes in physical shape, you can see, you can touch, now we have another concept. We call it services. And just think of our GDP, 60 to 70% of our GDP comes from service sector. And the important feature of services is that it's invisible. So when something is invisible, and that play a very, very important role, not only in your life, but also in your economy, then just think how, just give me 1 minute, okay. So just think how we need to understand these services, how to conduct a research when we talk about services. As you know, services are inseparable, services are invisible, and it's a very heterogeneous. Services by nature are heterogeneous. So when you conduct a research to understand the concept of services, which has become a very important part of marketing, which has become a very important part of business, because a lot of business, a lot of startup, they are targeting services activity because there is a huge, huge, huge demand, not only in India, abroad also. And the good thing about services is that no physically boundaries existing. If you come out with good idea, good solution, like for example, for me, learning something from Harvard Business School was a very difficult task. I mean, I can't afford, I can't go there. But thanks to online services, now we have different organization, they collaborated with Harvard, and they are supplying good study material, they are supplying good lecture online to all of us. Now, when you're supplying these all things online, that means you are providing services. So when you have services and you're supposed to conduct a research on services, it's gonna be a very, you know, unique and difficult task. But it would be all linked with creativity. It would be all linked with innovation. So if you get an idea that, okay, this is something that I think I should go for, I think I should start with. For example, I told you there is a concept of free tourism. I never heard of free tourism, that you don't have money, but someone is there who will help you, and they will not charge anything from you. But what do you need to do? You need to help them. Maybe the local product in local production of goods, local services they are offering. So you become a part of the team, and it would be a fun for you. So similarly, one very unique product I have seen yesterday. Maybe I will show you tomorrow. So this was what this is, you know, your glasses, you wear glass, the frame of the glass, it's made of bamboo, you know, sticks. Very organic, very difficult to make, like some frame for your glasses. So, I mean, this was something, and they say it's an organic, sustainable, and a unique idea. Just think of you know, product. And I was like you, I was studying in College of Business Studies. So 3M, 3M, I know you, I hope you understand what kind of product they have been offering. So 3M, they visited us and they wanted that suppose we give you this free of cost, what would be the use of this 3D 3M, the chit you put on, you know, your refrigerator to remember something or you mention some date, something like that. It's a kind of not notepad, right? So this was long time back, 1991, 1990, yeah. So before you bring that product, you need to test that product. You need to tell people why this product is so unique, why you should buy it. Is it linked somewhere with the fashion? Is it linked with somewhere with the environment or protecting environment, helping all of us? So you need to prove it. You need to come out with some creative idea. And this all comes when you understand the term called business research. So welcome again. And here you see one definition. According to Donald R. Cooper, I have read his book. It was an excellent book on business research. If you get a chance, if you're interested, I have all those these books I will be mentioning. It's all are foreigner books, foreign writer books. So Donald R. Cooper, what he has mentioned in his book, business research is a systematic inquiry that provides information to guide managerial decisions. So, systematic way of doing a particular task. Now, how we define it would be a systematic. There are some procedure, defined standard, and you follow this defined standard procedure, and then you will see that yes, this information is already there. You need to follow the information, and definitely it's going to help you in your managerial decisions. More specifically, it is a process of planning, acquiring, analyzing, and disseminating relevant data. So how do you take decision, especially a managerial decision? It is on the basis of some evidence. Evidence comes from the individual you know, remarks, individual inquiries. So we bring all together all your concern, all your issues, all your possible information, all your data, and this is our responsibility to procure you know, extract all this data, all this information, and secondly go and analyze the information. Analysis with the help of different tools, different techniques we have. And whatever information we feel that would be relevant, that relevant information we need to pass on to the decision maker. And or on the basis of that, we can take the decisions. And if you have the recent information, if you keep yourself updated, it really give you some kind of competitive advantage. And finally, when you have a competitive advantage, when you have a latest knowledge, when you have latest information, and you are taking a decision on the basis of the described rules and regulation and standards, then you will see you will have a maximized performance. Let me ask one question. You all are somewhere buying some products. Sometime your parents buying products on your behalf, or sometime you buy products on your family behalf, parents behalf, right? So now when you buy, are you conscious about the price? Are you looking forward for the quality of the product? Or sorry, you're looking something else. That how much efforts you made to make the whole transaction. So on the one side, the basic product, second, the quality of product, third, maybe the price is important. Fourth could be the effort you make to get that product, right? And next could be the convenience. When you see, when you buy a product, that you see that product, make a payment, and it will be delivered. It will deliver within 12 hours or 24 hours. Another thing beside that, these all things are very common for all of us, I believe. These things are very standardized format nowadays if you are interested in buying a product. But the issue comes when you have bought a product, now you're not happy with the product. What would be your reaction? What you will be doing? So the intention of a company who is supplying the product, actually you will see when they find that there is a problem in the product, then how this company react or act. So now you got a product, suppose you bought a television and it's not performing well, you have used it for 6 months and now you find a complaint, but you are not getting a good response. So here, what is important for all of us, it's not the quality, price, or convenience, but after-sales service. Because now, if suppose someone else asks you that, could you tell me which product I should buy? You bought a television. I'm interested in buying television. Can you tell me which product should I buy? Which brand should I buy? So here, if you have had a good experience with the organization in terms of services, in other things also, after sales services also, then definitely you're going to recommend. So what is important here? Nowadays, we are socially so much connected, right? Or socially, virtually we are connected, that whatever decisions we take, especially in business activity, buying activity, selling, marketing, we take advice from those who are not directly linked to us. For example, I wanted to buy vacuum cleaner. So if you go to a shop, one brand is available. Eureka Forbes brands are available. So I was curious to know what are the other brands available in India. So I checked on YouTube's, you know, lot of information is there. So these people, they say that we have been, you know, working on this. We know the different brands available. We know the quality. We know how to get these brands. Everything we know. So we are the expert. But I don't know who these people are. But I trust them because they are informing me. They are telling me. They are giving me knowledge. And I start believing in them. I start trusting in them. So that is what new things has emerged. Earlier, we were connected only with our, you know, close friends, close relative. But now, if you are planning to buy something, if you are thinking of new idea, you are connected with the whole world. And that is possible because of we have networking, we have social media. So here now you see, when you are buying a product, you need to understand the nitty-gritty, the pros and cons of social media also. These platforms are also playing a very, very important role. And these platforms give you information in terms of data. You analyze it and you give your insights. And these all things help you to take decision. I don't know how many of you actually buy the product on the basis of recommendation which comes from the social media. Let me see your remarks. How many of you really, really buy product on the basis of recommendations you see on social media? Let me see. Put your remarks in your chat box, everybody. Yes, please. Tell me in your chat box. Okay, Nishya say really? Okay. Go ahead. What about others? or you can unmute your mic also. Yeah, so maybe like Bhavya say mostly, so if I make a survey somewhere, we all are aware of that. What is the role of social media in our life? Okay, great, Himani, if you don't really do it, but at least you can get some awareness. You don't take your decisions, but now you are aware that, for example, in my case, I was interested in vacuum cleaner. So I had just one idea that in India you can get Eureka Forbes products. There may be one or two more, but actually, you have a different options. But vacuum cleaner is a product which, in which you need to understand the technology. You need to understand how to use it, what kind of feature it has, and different variant, different model available with different price. So that technicality, if you wish to understand, if you want to know, now you have a social media, you have people around. For example, I'm on a group with I've been attached with a group in Delhi NCR. Every day talk about plants, grow plants. Now every day they come out with an idea that okay, inside the home you should have this kind of plants, outside the home you should have this kind of plants. These plants are useful for air pollution, right? It cleans air. And I have bought this. You can also buy this. How to use these plants? How to grow plants? So now we have people. Thousands of people connected with us. If you have any query, answers are there, right? People are there to recommend. I don't know up to what extent you take their advice, but at least now you're aware that, okay, these things are popping up, these things are there. So these all things have is these all things are giving you some kind of idea. I remember I'm on three or four groups where we professors, teachers are connected with all of us. I don't know a lot of people from other country also. We all they are there on that group. So if there is any requirement that okay, someone is interested, that someone would like to invite to speak on social media, so they put information that if anyone is interested to speak on this, please call me. So this is what that you are connected. You at least aware that okay, there is a demand of this kind of idea, there is a demand of this kind of subject, there is a demand of this kind of goods and services. So now people are connected. And why I'm telling this? Because when you just think of, suppose you are planning to go to Manali, right? So if you're looking for accommodation, how you will process it? How will proceed further? Let me see your remarks, everybody. Will it be you will be calling someone over there? Or you will be searching accommodation in online? But where? Where you will be searching? Will it be a Google search or a particular website? Anish? Anish Mehto? Unmute your mic, please.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Tell me.
Sir, through some apps,
Okay, great. So
Lego
now you are
rooms
aware
and
of
others.
that. Now you are aware of that. Okay, Lego is there, other apps are there. Fine. What about Himani?
So there are certain apps which gives the specific information, so I would prefer the app.
So, which particular app you will just float and search on Google, or you have some idea that okay, these are the apps?
So firstly, I would recommend to ask the people who have already visited the Manali. If there
Okay,
would be
very
no
good.
one,
So,
then
where
I
you visit these people?
Sir, firstly, I will look at in my relation, or I will ask from my friends, is there anyone who has already visited Manali? If there would
So.
no one, then I surely go to the Google I'll Google the particular app or the website which is working for the recommendation and for the telling the places in the Manali. So
Right.
that would work.
This is the common approach, as Himani has mentioned, that generally when we are looking for a particular services, we talk to our friends, and then we search on Google. In my case, what I do, last year, in October, November, I was keen to go to Nainital, Ranikhet, these places, Jim Corbett Park. So I was, as you put this information on Google search, a lot of information will pop up. So now, if you don't know anything about this new places, other places, or maybe your friends are not aware of, like me, I have just one or two friends, not more than that. So I become the leader always, and I tell them that, okay, hey, I visited this, these were the places, these were the different accommodation I used, so why don't you go? So they go and then they use this. So you need some people that who take this decision first to go and find out different options. So options comes always from these kind of social media platforms. Why these social media platforms have become? Because we all know that and these are playing very, very important role, especially in COVID-19. So now just see, research has shifted from few people, those who were very close to you, those who were has known to you. Now the whole world, you never know from where the information will come. As you know that I got this channel, my YouTube channel on teaching and learning, and I got approximately 570 subscribers, and most of them are PhD scholars. And every day one or two comments I receive. So someone say that, why don't you put playlist? So I did it. Someone say that you put a link, why don't you put this link in the description so that we can see that and they can click it directly. So I did it. And every day I receive a message, sir, I am from this place, I am from this place. So not only from India, I am covering the whole India, but from other country also, nearby country, they give comments. So this is what, that with one initiative, you are connected with a lot of people. But all this is dependent on the way you see it, the way you conduct it. But for that, you need to go through a particular system. You need to go through a procedure, and that procedure and system is actually a research. So we talk about that. Let me share. Let me continue with what we have been talking about. And here you see a Donald Cooper definition, and then we go to what is a good research, as I mentioned. So one definition, other definition also we have. I will share with you. So what is a good research? So research, now you understand, as according to Cooper, to Donald R. Cooper, business research is a systematic inquiry. So it's a particular system you need to follow and provide information to guide managerial decisions. Here, what kind of information you would be needed, what kind of system you would be needed so that you can take good managerial decisions. First, here you can see clearly define object. What is your object? Your object is to secure maximum marks. Your object is learning. Your object is, it's not always necessary that you secure highest marks and you say that I am the person, I know everything, right? So learning is a different concept. For example, billions of people, billions of students, they come to school. Do you think they all learning over there? So here you need to define what is the main object. You need to clearly define. We'll talk about that. Second is detailed research process. You know that this is my object, very clear-cut object. For example, nowadays, when you buy a camera, suppose you want to buy a video camera, what are you looking for? Are you looking for a product only, that this is just a product? Or when you buy a camera, it's not only satisfied your need to picturize a particular moment, but more than that, sometime it become a matter of pride. It become it's linked with your status also. So you cannot buy any camera, right? You need to decide, okay, this particular camera fit according to my need. That is one thing. Camera is camera, but it's not camera is camera is not camera here. It has different dimensions which describe your personality. It describes what kind of needs you have. And when you use it, right, then you realize, oh, it got this kind of feature also. I never know that. So this is what when you buy something, it's not only a basic product you're buying, you are buying other things also, which comes with the product. And that may be in terms of satisfaction, quality, experience, happiness, brand. A lot of things come with your product. And second thing, detailed research process. You need to understand this detailed research process. We'll talk about that. And very important thing, when you conduct a research, are you aware of ethical values, our customs, rules, regulation? Then limitation of the research, that you can't do everything, because as a human being, we also have some limitation that you cannot observe, you cannot, take into consideration all other dimensions which may sometime affect. For example, I remember there was a case in Uttar Pradesh. There was a community, and in that community there were two schools. And fortunately, unfortunately, school A was performing so well for past 10, 12 years, and school B was not so well, I mean, in terms of student performance. So it was an excellent case study, and the local government, they wanted to understand why this is so. And it's an example of Ghaziabad, not far away. Same people, same community, same kind of teachers, same, everything was same. Students were coming from nearby area, same community. Teachers were same, I mean, because they have a recruitment process from government organized. They were part of government institute. They are actually a government institution schools. These two government schools, but everything was same. Everything was same over there. Same resources, same chalkboard, teachers, students also, they are from same community. But one school was performing well and other school was not so performing well. So the government, the local government, they were interested to understand what is the reason that a lot of student they perform well from this school A, but those who come to school B, they are not able to perform well. So they saw that there is a one limitation in school B. Can you believe that limitation was that in school A and school B, all things were same. In school A, they observe that students, they play and they have a playground. And school B, unfortunately, was not having sports ground. It was a very unique kind of case study that sports also play a very, very important role in your personality development. So you never know what would be the limitation of your research. Here it was something very unique. So when you talk about research, you need to think about the limitation also, that you cannot observe, you cannot feel, you cannot see all other dimensions which may be somewhere controlling your environment, controlling your information, or putting some impact on your decision making. Next come the sufficient data for analysis. This may mean the another big issue, big problem, that do you think, because for example, just think of Delhi University. We have approximately now more than 600,000 students. And I want to do some research on the students learn teaching learning approach, especially during COVID-19, and it's in virtual form. So can I access all these 600,000 students? It's going to be very difficult for me. So what I do, I instead of approaching all 600,000 6 lakh student, it would be better to take a sample size, and this sample size will represent this 6 lakh students in Delhi University. Now, the problem over here is, what would be the sample size? Will it be 300, 400, 500, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 5,000? So how much data would be sufficient? It remain a problem, it remain a issue. We'll talk about that, why you should have maximum number of samples in your research. And secondly, we need to put somewhere a full stop, that beyond that you cannot go. If you go, it would be like a diminishing rate, marginal rate of diminishing. You remember the economics, you might have done this topic. Marginal rate of, diminishing rate of return, something like that, marginal or diminishing rate. So same thing happen if you go beyond, number, it may be there's no use of more than 300 in one case, 500 in another. So we'll talk about justification, that what should be the sample size. Now comes the presentation of findings. So whatever analysis you have made with the help of statistical tools and techniques, with statistical methods, you need to present these all methods. And when you're presenting, it would be in terms of number, but number you need to justify, that these are numbers, but why these number, and what is the interpretation of this number, how to interpret this number, that play a very, very important role. For that, you need to read more, you need to develop argument, you need to find out premises. For the example I mentioned in Ghaziabad case, I mean, you come out with a number, student marks, one school, not so good, another school, excellent, teacher ratio, same, student ratio, same, everything same. How you can predict when you're supposed to make a presentation, how the sports ground, which is missing in school B, gonna affect the performance of the student. For that, you need to justify your conclusion. So that is what creativity, that is what you need to be a bit innovative. You need to develop argument, you need to be smart enough to defend your argument. And for that, we have this research subject. And the beauty of this research is, here next you see interdisciplinary approach. It's not only about business, it's not only about accountancy, mathematics, it's about psychology, it's about philosophy, it's about the quality of human life, it's about understanding the perception, it's about understanding motivation among people, it's about why people behave in a certain manner. So it's about economics, it's about finance. So different discipline altogether, management. So all these together, if you bring all these together, these all subject, then you will see that this research will help you to understand the main cause, main issue, main problem, and definitely will offer some kind of solution for you. So here, let me put more light on what we have been talking about today, that is about what is good research. So here you see, first, clearly define object. The object of business research, the problem at hand and the decision to be made should be clearly defined. So it's not only a problem, because object would be to sort out some problem, to find out some problem. So here you must know what is the main problem and find out what is the main objective. The decision making should include its scope, limitation, and clear meaning of the words and terms important to the research. For example, you remember we talk about intelligence, we talk about motivation. So intelligence, understanding what is intelligence, for example, beauty, aesthetics, values. For example, beauty may be some ugly also a kind of beauty. As I you remember we discussed, I've been to Bihar fortunately and I saw Madhubin painting, so attractive, so good. Another painting, Manjusha painting, a bit ugly, but it's also, you know, painting, it's also something which is different, but it is also a painting. So some people like this kind of painting, some people like another kind of painting. So it depends, but it's all art. It's all beautiful. It's all beautiful. Small is also beautiful. Big is also beautiful. For some people, small is beautiful. For some people, big is beautiful. So what we need to do, we need to understand scope, limitation, and more than that, the words, meaning, and different terms we have been using. Second, detailed research process. This includes the steps to identify target participants, their consent to use data, sampling method, and data gathering procedures, etc. Enabling the researchers to conduct the research and enable its use in future. It should also mention the source of data and recommendation based on data analysis. We'll talk about this all, how to collect data, what should be the what we call consent to use data. Then the very important thing over here, which has been become very important in past 2-3 years. I have been teaching this research ethics in Delhi University to PhD students in MCOM department. Reason was this, that there was a hue and cry in Indian, you know, academia, that there is a term called predatory journals. We'll talk about that. So there was a lot of issues. There was a lot of hue and cry. And that's why UGC has introduced, government has introduced this ethical subject called research and publication ethics. So here ethical standards means data integrity and moral concern should be a priority when applying and practicing the research in society. Physical and psychological harm to the respondent and the participants, invasion of privacy, loss of dignity must be given careful consideration during the research. And then limitation of the research, as I said, that you cannot do everything yourself. So here we need to mention what is the flaws in research design, where is the flaws in the research design, and what would be the possible impact if we have these findings and we recommend them. There are very few perfect research design. And here the main concern would be in terms of reliability and validity. We'll talk about that. What is reliability and what is the validity? And here we have discussed that what, how much data would be the sufficient data. Adequate data for the analysis should be made available to the researchers so that they can take the right decision. It should give possible information and insights to compare options and select the appropriate approach. Data should be classified with the help of analysis and should keep and should help decision makers to reach at a decision. And as I mentioned, that we need to present the data, it should be reasonably described, interpreted, comprehensive, and understandable. And then we need to give some justifiable conclusion. And here your personal bias you need to keep aside. You should give whatever outcome you have received on the basis of your analysis. And the beauty of research is it's an interdisciplinary approach. A good research must be based on interdisciplinary approach where it should collaborate with other disciplines to understand to the nature of the problem effectively and should even assist in designing the framework of the research. So, we will continue with this I hope now you understand what is research, what is good research. And next topic we're gonna cover would be tomorrow would be different types of research. Different types of research.